Everyone, welcome you all to the lecture video series on module number 3, social responsibilities of business and entrepreneurship, from the subject management and entrepreneurship. And the name itself says that it is the social responsibility of any business, any organization that is running its business in the neighborhood area, and what is the contribution to the society that the organization is making. Let's understand all the points of the social entrepreneurship, where the social responsibilities of the business means what? What is the meaning of the social responsibility in the true senses? What is the social responsibility of any business that is running in a local area, or it is going to whether it is going to cater the different groups of society or not? What is exactly social audit, and how it is different from the other audits, kind of financial audit, kind of internal audit, and all these audits that takes place in an organization? What is business ethics, which is going to have a larger meaning? And what is corporate governance? And in the entrepreneurship, which is the second part of this module, we are going to learn about who is an entrepreneur, what is the definition of an entrepreneur, how the entrepreneur is different from an employee of an organization, what are the characteristics of an entrepreneur, what is exactly the importance of entrepreneurship in a society, and what is the concept of entrepreneurship altogether, and what are the characteristics of a successful entrepreneur, why the entrepreneur should treat the failure as a success also, and what is the new meaning of the intrapreneur, and how an intrapreneur emerge in an entrepreneurship sector or in an corporate, and why the intrapreneurship is very, very important to an corporate, and how they should be facilitated in an corporate, and what is the comparison, how do we compare, and what are the different traits of entrepreneur and intrapreneur, and what are the myths about the entrepreneurship, what is exactly the normal tendency of any public to think about the entrepreneurship, what are the myths, and what is entrepreneurship, entrepreneurial development models, and how the entrepreneurship can be developed in the different groups, starting from the students, starting from the organizations, educational institutions, and what are the different models, the entrepreneurship development models that can be given to the different parts of society, different people in the society, and what is the entrepreneurial development cycle, how exactly it should start and where exactly it is going to emerge, and what are the general problems that are faced by the entrepreneurs, and it is totally dependent on the situation. So what are the different problems, and what are the barriers to the entrepreneurship, or how to build the capacity of the entrepreneurs, and how do we make the capacity building in the entrepreneurship sector? All these we are going to study in the social responsibilities of business and entrepreneurship in the module 3. Let's take up the social responsibilities of business, and how do we define the social responsibilities of the business. There are many management thinkers who have worked out in this particular sector, social responsibilities, which has got a huge meaning. And whenever a company or an organization sets up its business in a local area, what is their responsibility towards the different group who are working in that area? Because they are utilizing the human resources, they are utilizing all the infrastructure that is available in that particular area. And what is the contribution of the organization that is given back to the society? And according to Kate Davis, social responsibilities refers to a businessman's decisions and actions that is taken to reason out, that is taken to reasons at least partially beyond the firm's direct economic or the technical interest. So what is the interest of the entrepreneur to give back to the society by utilizing the resources that are available in that area? According to Andrews, by social responsibilities, we mean intelligent and objective concern for the welfare of the society that restrains individual and corporate behavior from ultimately destructive activities, no matter how immediately profitable, and leads in the direction of the positive direction contribution to human betterment, variously as the latter may be defined. So it must ensure that the social responsibility of any kind of organization means that it is going to meet the objective through the intelligent way, and the objective is to make the betterment of the society surrounding the organization, and it is not going to be individual focus, but it is going to focus on the mass, and they have to restrain from the destructive activities by not spoiling the environment that was existing, and by not harming the society, local society. If at all it is situated in the place where the tribals are located, then we must make sure that the interest of the society is taken care of. HR Brown says that a business manager is bound to pursue those policies, to make those decisions, or to follow those lines of action which are desirable in terms of objectives and values of our society. So everywhere, at every point of the decision, the values of the society have to be taken care of. Then the organization is bound to have the social responsibilities towards the group or to the society that they are surrounded with. Let's understand the responsibilities to various groups. When the social responsibility of the business, if an organization exists, what are the social responsibility of the business towards each one of the society? And business owes a lot to the various groups, such as customers, clients, employees, shareholders, government, and the community at large where it exists. So these groups are known as the interest groups or stakeholders in any modern organization. We can see here that the social responsibility of the business surrounds the shareholders or the investors, employees or workers, consumers or customers, government or the community and the administrative bodies where it exists, local community, environment, and general public. So the social responsibility of the business is interconnected with all these who are called as stakeholders. Responsibility towards the customers. Let us treat each one of them in a separate way. Let's understand what is the social responsibility of the business towards the customers. Then we will understand about the employees. Then we will understand the social responsibility towards the shareholders. Let's start with the customers. Let's understand the customer is the king. So the responsibility towards the customer, what is the social responsibility that the organization carries towards the customer, is that business should provide the goods and the services at an affordable and a reasonable price so that the customer will come back and then buy the products from a company. So it should make the fair price, and it should also release the products with the reasonable prices. And business should provide the quality or the standard goods to the society. There should not be any inferior quality of the product that could be released, which is going to disrupt the surrounding environment. So the product that is released by the business from the business concern should be at the right standard. So the solving the customer complaint, if the customer finds a complaint with the product, then they should come back, and then the organization should be able to solve the customer complaint. It may be with respect to the inferior quality, it may be with respect to the quantity, it may be with respect to anything that is that is released by the business concern. So the business organization should be able to collect the information from the customer in terms of it through the feedbacks about the needs of the customer, about the preferences of the customer, about the likes and the dislikes of the customer. Normally this will be collected as a feedback. You might have filled the feedback to the product that you are using. So similarly, this will be conducted through the surveys, and there will be lot of research that will be going on the customer needs and the customer satisfactions, customer likes and dislikes, through the researchers that are going to take care. And normally the market researcher will be able to give this survey and the research to the marketing department. Details of the weight, price, expiry date should be there on the packaging. So you might have on the packing, whenever you go to a mall or whenever you go to any kind of shop to buy any product, first you will normally observe what is the packing date, and what is the expiry date, what is the warranty period, and what is exactly the amount or the quantity that is inside the packing. And you will also observe whether it is the fair price that is given to the packing. Honest advertising, you should not simply say anything about it. You might have observed it long back, you might have observed that celebrities are given a code of conduct saying that if at all they use that product, then only they will be eligible to advertise the product. So there should be code of conduct in the honest, and there should be honesty in the advertising. Whatever that you produce, whatever the celebrities say, they have to practice that and they have to use that product, then only they can come for the advertising. So there will be it will avoid the false information towards any product. And about the ingredients of the product, you might have observed the Maggi noodles case that has come up, and then that has made the celebrities to think over to advertise any product without even using it. So after the sales service, the humble behavior should be there, and that should also be observed across the counters, and there should be sufficient quantity, and the quantity cannot be cheated onto the customers. So the customers are the kings, and then as long as the customer stays with the business organization, it is the due responsibility of the business organization to owe the responsibility towards the customers about the products. Let's understand the second responsibility towards the employees. The second responsibility, that is towards the employees, is something which is very, very important. So employee, once the selection of the employee goes, that the proper selection of the employees should be done, proper training to be given to the employees, proper impartial promotion should be observed with the hierarchy or to the next post that the people are going to have, depending on the merits and depending on the contribution that they are giving to the organization. And improper selection cannot be entertained, and improper transfers should also be stopped. So there should not be any kind of biased look for the transfers that is to be done. So next one is to provide the opportunity and the sense of to build the sense of loyalty towards the company. That has to be done through the to the employees, and to create the business organization has to create a good working condition, and they should make sure that the cordial relationship to be established among the employees in the organization, which is going to boost the production and which is going to motivate each other so that they will be able to work as a team. So to introduce the code of conduct for the workers and the employees. So the code of conduct should be established by the organization. It should be well loved on their websites, on their social media, on their, you know, code of conduct to be printed as well, and it should be made as the document, and it should be kept ready for anybody's reference. And there should be enough job security, and there should not be any kind of insecurity in the job, which is going to be a negative approach and which is going to demotivate the workers. So there should be proper job security that is to be given to the employees, and there should be fair wages, and then the salaries should be at par with any other competitor, and salary should not be very low, and the wages that is the paid to the workers should also be at par. And the business organization should initiate appropriate measure for the development of the employees and the resources. There should be increase in the productivity, there should be optimal utilization of the human resources, and also there should be recognition to be given to the efficiency that is shown by the workers. There should be a recognition of the merit. It could be tangible or intangible, it could be a bonus or it could be a letter of appreciation also. So the third one is a responsibility towards the shareholders. Shareholders are the one who have invested their money, having a belief or the trust in the organization. So the business organization has to establish a security to their funds, and a fair rate of return should be there to their investment. If the returns is low, then they are going to take out their money from the investment and they are going to invest it in some other concern. And the business organization has to provide the accurate information on the working of the business, whether it is a rewarding business or whether it is undergoing the loss or there is a stagnancy in the product, in the market. Everything should be informed to the shareholders. The business organization has to treat all the shareholders equally and without any bias. One shareholder may be having 10,000 shares, other shareholder may be having one share, but both of them should be treated equally because they are the shareholders. And the business organization has to take necessary steps to expand the business. There has to be, they have to attract the external funding, they have to attract, they have to internally expand their growth, in the, expand the product range. Everything should be taken care so that the shareholders would love to remain in the organization and they will have the strong trust in the in the growth of the organization. And they have to, the organization has to carry out the R&D, that is a research and development, to improve the product and the services. So this is the responsibility of the organization towards the shareholders, that is to be taken care of because it attracts the external funding. With this, we are going to close this lecture video session on the responsibility, social responsibility of the organization towards the stakeholders. See you all in the next lecture video session on the upcoming next one is the responsibility towards the government. Upcoming topics. See you all in the next lecture video session. Thank you very much.